Welcome to another camera channel. In this video, we're going to be looking at noise reduction in Adobe Audition. Noise reduction is a huge topic, and I want to make a more in-depth video about all the different techniques of noise reduction and the situations they're good for. So if you want to see that video, please comment down below and give this video a big thumbs up. I'm going to teach you very briefly the basic noise reduction effect that I use all the time. Once I learned this technique, it changed my life when it came to reducing noise, as I found that all the basic effects in Final Cut Pro or Premiere were making my audio sound all mangled and horrible. No one wants to listen to a video that sounds like this. We're going to need to use headphones whenever we're doing anything with audio, so make sure you have yours on. And you're in an environment which isn't affecting your hearing. Ready to go? Let's jump right now into Adobe Audition. Open your file. In the waveform view, you'll see your recorded sound. In my case, it's this. Welcome to another camera channel. Today, we're going to be looking at noise reduction in Adobe Audition. Now that sounds pretty good because the microphone is very close to my face, but there is an underlying rumble and hiss that we want to get rid of. If I boost the levels, you'll hear what I mean. This is all the ambient noise in the room, like the fridge, the fans on the lights, the dry cleaners above us, and the noise floor of the microphone. I want to remove this sound, but leave my voice intact. On the waveform, we can barely see that there's any noise there at all. But by dragging this bar at the bottom of the waveform up, we can see the spectral frequency display. Now we can see where the sound falls in the frequency range and how loud it is. No sound is represented as black, moving through purple, red, orange, all the way to yellow being the loudest. If I change the spectral resolution here by right-clicking on the Hertz range, or by using Shift, Command, and up and down keys, we can see the frequencies a lot easier. There are these noticeable bands running through the file with a lot of the noise between the 20 to 400 Hertz range, trailing off to the 1K Hertz mark, with my voice data, which looks kind of like salmon sashimi meat, between the 80 Hertz to 10,000 Hertz range. I'm gonna go to Effects, Noise Reduction Restoration, Noise Reduction Process. And this effects window pops up. Now I need to capture a noise print before we can do anything. Using this part of the recording when I'm not speaking, we can get a good sample of the noise that we want to remove. Make sure to check that you're not capturing any swallowing sounds, any clothes rustling, or breathing. Once we're happy with our selection, hit the Capture Noise Print button. We can now see our noise print pattern displayed here. Let's run over the controls. The noise reduction slider controls how much we're applying the effect. Are we removing 100% of the noise, or are we letting a little bit sneak through? The reduce by slider sets the amount of reduction in terms of volume. There may be some situations where you only want to reduce the noise by a few dB. The output noise only toggle allows you to hear the noise that's being removed from your recording during preview. Welcome to another camera channel. Today, we're going to be looking at noise reduction in Adobe Audition. If I click the apply button now, I will be left with just the noise in the file, removing everything else. This may be useful in some situations. Under Advanced, we see some more controls. Spectral Decay Rate is a control to help bridge the gap between what gets taken away and what remains. 0% is very harsh, and increasing the percent allows more of that noise to bleed through. Welcome to another camera channel. Today, we're going to be looking at noise reduction in Adobe Audition. Welcome to another camera channel. Today, we're going to be looking at noise reduction in Adobe Audition. Smoothing, again, helps the transition between your sound and what is being removed. Increasing smoothing is meant to help reduce that noticeable garbling noise that you get when applying noise reduction. Precision factor controls how hard you want Audition to work when applying noise reduction. A low precision factor value will allow you to play back in real time, but it may not do the job as well. Whereas a higher precision factor value will take longer to apply the effect and therefore may not be able to play back in real time, but it will be more accurate. You should be able to find a happy medium between time taken and quality. Transition width is another control which works with blending the noise removal with what remains. 0 dB of transition width means a harsh cutoff. All of these controls will vary with the situation and the noise you're trying to remove. Noise print capture settings sets the amount of frequency bands that are being analyzed. We're going to set this to 4096, and you can pretty much use that setting all the time. Looking at this blue line in the frequency display, we can see it's applying noise reduction evenly across the spectrum. If we wanted to only apply noise reduction in the lower frequencies or just reduce the amount of noise reduction in the higher frequencies, you can click and drag points on the line to suit your needs. For my example, I'm going to listen to the recording while adjusting the settings. Welcome to another camera channel. Today, we're going to be looking at noise reduction in Adobe Audition. Welcome to another camera channel. Today, we're going to be looking at noise reduction in Adobe Audition. These are the settings I'm happy with, so I'm going to go ahead and hit apply. Welcome to another camera channel. Today, we're going to be looking at noise reduction in Adobe Audition. Now this is sounding really good, so it's ready to go on to the next stage of effects and processing. When applying noise reduction, keep in mind that applying too much can make it sound unnatural, so adjust your settings accordingly so it's not too overpowered. Thanks for watching this video. If you found it useful and I saved your project, please let us know in the comments below. Subscribe if you feel like it, and if you need a studio in Seoul, South Korea, check out our studio Instagram at ThereForYou.